So this whole idea about, well, there are people who are protesting the dismantling or the removal of a statue, okay? Mm. You're just a normal person who's there. You don't like the statue being taken down. And then all of a sudden you see people with signs calling people, you know, the N-word, mm-hmm. and making monkey, you hear them making monkey noises, mm-hmm. Calling out the black folks in the crowd, saying Jews will not replace us. If you're a very fine person, what do you do? Do you say, oh, I'm going to go march with those people?
You leave.
So Jake Tapper, very brilliant question to Kellyanne Conway. Who were the very fine people? She didn't answer, couldn't answer it.
So today
they
had an
answer. Who were the very fine people?
So today they went back
Who's
to the
that?
New York Times and said that they, remember, they interviewed this woman at the time who said, I'm about free speech. And I like, yeah, but she wasn't marching with the Nazis. She was there
right.
to say, I think we should have this discussion. These things mean something in the South. Now, look, that's debatable. I don't know what the relevant cultural value is of something that represents slavery in a country that fought against it. It's a mm-hmm. debate you want to have? Fine. But they're conflating it, and I don't know why, Don. I know what the suggestion can be. Well, he does it because he likes this. I think it's something worse. I really do. Because people who you grew up with, who judged you that way because of the color of your skin, in
right.
general, ignorant, raised in a vacuum, somehow tainted, somehow damaged, or maybe just pure out evil. But it's usually some kind of combination. But the man who perverts that anger and uses it for advantage, that's mm-hmm. a different kind of human being. That's not about ignorance.
Well,
that's about advantage.
You took the words right out of my mouth, because I was just going to say, one of my probably my best friend in my later adult years now is a friend named Jamie who lives in Georgia, born and raised in Georgia. When I worked at CNN in Atlanta, we became very good friends. And we would talk about issues of race. He's this white guy, red hair. You know, we couldn't be any more different, but we're really good friends. And we talk about the Confederate flag all the time. And he couldn't understand. He said, my parents and the people around me taught that this meant Southern pride. And then when I started to educate him and I told him what he should read and explore, he started to realize that that flag wasn't necessarily about Southern pride and actually what it meant to other groups of people, and that that flag was being used to fight for really something that was treasonous and something that was reprehensible, which was the enslavement of people who looked like me. And then in the end, he realized, he said, well, I cannot condone that if I'm going to have a friend like you, then what has been told to me does not make sense.
Yeah, you know when you keep the flag? When the streets are filled in protest with African Americans. When the African Americans
right.
say, we want to keep the flag, we want to keep the statues, then you know that it's about cultural adaptation and memories of a heritage that is worth preserving. But I'm
right.
telling you, this Trump trifecta is real. You're going to have the economics. You're going to have competing plans and competing people. But I'm telling you, abortion, immigration, right-wing extremism, they all play to the same persuasion sensibilities in certain voters. Him saying
Fear.
That a newborn child can be swaddled and then executed. Mm. The president of the United States saying something so dumb, so
yep.
grossly inaccurate. I've never heard him lie any worse, Don, than if he called himself Frankie.
Yeah. Well, it could be. I mean, he can say, my grandfather used to call me Frankie, and then he would, you know.
What is bigger than this? He's saying yeah. that people want to kill babies for real.
And it's not true. But I will let me say this before I move on to this show. If you believe in the history of this country, you should read it. If you want to have statues, that's fine. If you want to have the flag, that's fine. Put them in a museum that can explain correctly the significance of those objects and those monuments. They don't have to be displayed. I'm just wondering, listen, and I know this is an extreme example and I've used it before, Robert E. Lee High School. There was a Robert E. Lee mm-hmm. High School in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, where I come from. Would people want to go to a school that was named Hitler High School? Would you want a statue of Hitler erected anywhere in the United States? Those things mean the same thing to African Americans as the other things mean to Jewish people, Jewish Americans. So just think about that, America, before you say this is history and it's our pride and all of that. Fine. But it represents the worst of our country, and not the best of our country.
And that is the one piece of context that people need to remember about what the president was saying around Charlottesville. He was siding with the people who want to keep the statues and saying, well, where do we end? Jefferson, George Washington? Now, there's a meaningful distinction. It's not about just having owned slaves. It's about when there was a line drawn in the sand about what this country would be about, which side were you on of that line? It's different. To say Washington, Jefferson, that's about picking men in the moment in which they lived and what their weaknesses were. Fine.
Yeah.
Fine cultural criticism. It's different than the Civil War. It's different than the role that was played there and the decisions that was made. I'm just telling you, Don, I'm telling you, he's touching these buttons for a reason, and I'm not saying he's a bigot. I'm not saying he holds these things in his heart. He keeps them in his head because he thinks they work, and that's dangerous.